In this video, I'm going to explain the mechanics of thoracic outlet syndrome. There are three places that can create thoracic outlet syndrome. So I will explain one by one. Actually, there are many reasons to create thoracic outlet syndrome. Maybe whiplash, maybe repetitive motion, maybe car accident, because of American football, rugby, contact sports, martial arts. These can create thoracic outlet syndrome. So, the first place is around neck area. There is two muscles. Actually, this is one muscle. The one muscle can create pain around here. You see these two red tapes? These two red tapes represent scalene muscle. Actually, this one, front one, represents anterior scalene. This one is middle scalene. You see this yellow wire tape here? This yellow one represents nerve. This is brachial plexus. If you look carefully here, brachial plexus passes through in between anterior scalene and middle scalene. So what if scalene gets tight, especially anterior part and middle part? This can pinch the brachial plexus. What happens if nerve got impingement? It can create pain, right? So if you got a car accident, maybe this guy got a car accident and whiplash, or somebody got hit, a trauma here, it can decrease this space. Then it will tighten up the brachial plexus, then it will create pain. So, relationship in between brachial plexus and scalene muscle is very, very important. Actually, there's one more structure passes in between scalene anterior and scalene middle, which is subclavian artery. That is very big artery. It will send blood to head and shoulder and arm. It's very big artery. Then that passes in between scalene as well. This is very important. So this is first place, scalene and brachial plexus. The next one is here. You see this blue tape? Actually, this blue tape model is not 100% accurate. This tape represents subclavius. Actually, in reality, subclavius attaches below the clavicle. But in this video, I just give you the simple version of model. So in this case, it's easy to visualize where subclavius is. Again, subclavius attaches below clavicle. You have to note this. So what is important about subclavius? The function of subclavius is lower down the clavicle. It pulls down the clavicle. What is that about? Why is that so important with thoracic outlet syndrome? Let's see in this place. In normal position, this first rib and clavicle, there's space in between first rib and clavicle. This space is very narrow, even in normal position. This is very narrow. So what if subclavius pulls clavicle down? It will even diminish this space. And what's there? Brachial plexus is here. So subclavius pulls down the clavicle. It will decrease space here and it can pinch brachial plexus. It's very important. See, it passes through posterior to clavicle. So relationship among subclavius, clavicle, brachial plexus are very important. This is second place. So last place, third place is here. Brachial plexus pass posterior to this red tape. What's this red tape? This is pectoralis minor, which is a shoulder girdle muscle. This pectoralis minor is very important for scapular movement. Brachial plexus pass posterior to pectoris minor. What if this gets tight? It will diminish the disc posterior space, then it can create pain here. So these three spaces, scalene anterior and middle, subclavius, and pectoris minor, these three spaces are very narrow even in normal position. Then again, what if this guy got whiplash or car accident or head trauma? It can decrease each spaces or all of them. These three spaces are very important for thoracic outlet syndrome. Maybe you can stretch yourself, go to a chiropractor, go to massage therapy, or go to rehab. These three spaces very, very important for thoracic outlet syndrome. So in this video, I explained the mechanics of thoracic outlet syndrome and why it could happen. First place, scalene anterior, scalene middle, and brachial plexus. Second part is subclavius, clavicle, brachial plexus. The third place was pectoris minor and brachial plexus. So this is today's video. I hope this video helps your understanding of thoracic outlet syndrome. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.